Yeah, I'm really like, here, let me just do this. Whoop.
There you go. That works. You're not on Threads, right?
No, I don't do Threads. I'm trying not to do social media as much anymore at all.
Oh, it's awful, social media. I just looked at this post because you're like, what are we going to talk about on this podcast? And I just looked up this post that is like, I see it all the time now, and it's just become this cesspool. But a girl, Goldie Lynn, I believe her name was, photography, she posted about how a client gave her a 1-star review on Google, or maybe it was Facebook or something. I think it was Google. 1-star review because she didn't like her prices. Didn't book her, didn't do anything besides inquire, and gave her a 1-star review because that not even a customer didn't like.
That's a dick move.
It's such a dick move. But it gets worse. So I comment, you know, I'm so sorry this happened to you, right? And right before we hit record, I'm like, oh, let me pull this actual thing up so I can tell the story about it. And it says, post not available, Goldie Lynn imagery. And then I look at her, and one day ago, she wrote, it's so disheartening how ugly so many people can be behind a keyboard and a screen. Please be kind to people. Even if you disagree, you can still be kind. And I know darn well that post is in response. She probably had to delete her post where she was upset about the 1-star review from her, not even her customer.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Because photographers in there just jump in it, to, you know, be divisive and right. to show the other side. And I feel like I see this constantly.
That's social media, though. That's been like that forever. But social media has always been like, it started with the Facebook groups. I remember the yeah. videographer Facebook group was the most yeah. toxic cesspool. And I know some of the people in there, they're good people, but they get online and they, and I swear this is one guy, you could post that the sky is blue, he'll say you're wrong.
Right, and they do.
He's just an asshole in that respect. And I can't stand it. Like, I had to leave just because I don't like to be around people who just act like that.
Yeah. It's like, what is missing in your life?
If you look at this person, he's the typical kind of keyboard warrior. It's
but
sad.
He's not that way in person.
Probably not. I've never met the guy in person because I know he wouldn't say half the stuff he says to me on Facebook. He wouldn't say any of that if we were face to face, you know, which is 90% of people out there.
But that's also within industry, which we'll get to in a second because I have another thing I just saw about that. That's within industry. And I feel like, yeah, that's been around for a while. But the whole like consumer bashing a brand, which yeah. is not even a brand. It's not even like you went and decided to go leave Target a bad review, right?
Yeah, right.
It's attacking a small business over the fact that you didn't like her prices.
Yeah, well, the problem is there's no repercussions.
What the heck?
Right, there's
oh,
no...
I'm sorry, everything isn't catered to you because that's what it is this generation, and maybe I'm the old person saying this, everyone is used to things being catered to them, including the ads.
The ads, the ads, right.
Everything is catered to them. So yeah. when something is not for them,
right.
aka you can't afford it.
Well, everybody, so.
Not even can't afford it, but like don't value it that way. Like that's a reason to like go off the handle.
It's also people are triggered so easily by everything nowadays. I mean, you know, we've all seen this in social media and just the social construct of the world because of social media. Everybody gets triggered and, you know, mm-hmm. offended over everything. And the yeah. problem is there's no repercussions to what you say anymore, right? Mm-hmm. It used to be if you were on the schoolyard, if you said something to somebody's face that was offensive, you get your teeth knocked out, right? Now on the internet, nobody gets their teeth knocked out. Well, I mean, you can say whatever the hell you want.
Like Sepia Bride got her teeth knocked out.
Yeah, she got her reputation damaged and she's okay, right?
No, she didn't have to go to what? She's getting a divorce. Yeah, you know crap. That had to do.
I'll tell you what. That woman was getting divorced whether she posted that bullshit or not. That was not a marriage. She is not a wifeable woman. She is not wifeable. I'm sorry. Anybody that complains like that. Like, that's. I've dated women in the past who, like, would complain at every fucking meal at the restaurant.
Which one?
Oh, gee.
Well, to go C
or
B.
Should I say the name?
No, C, B, or L.
B. I like this. Let's play CBL with Rob Adams. This was B.
This was B. Okay.
And B.
A little bit of a cokehead, just to preface.
Yeah, she was a little bit of a coke. This is before she even got heavy into coke. She was just every time. She was the original. She was the OG of, what's the word I'm looking for? A woman who is Karen. Like, no, she's not a Karen. She was like entitled. But oh, like, okay. She, before social media made every chick entitled, or to, you know, look at me, she had this thing about dressing up and going out on the town and feeling high society, right?
Okay.
And she had no money to be high society. I had no money at the time to be high society, but every once in a while we'd go out to a nice restaurant.
Okay.
And she would complain because I feel like nice she,
because that made
the
her
duck confit like, would come,
than, yeah,
and she would complain, and it was perfectly fine. It was almost like this: if I don't complain, then I'm not getting my money worth.
Yes, like you don't have a voice.
Yeah, because the experience had to be maximized by her grabbing of attention.
Do you think it was attention, or like maybe I think get something for free?
No, it was more attention because she wasn't looking for something for free. She was looking to get attention. Because
you were paying for it.
She was exactly getting something. That's exactly for free. Right. But that's so many people nowadays, and so many women. I'm not targeting women. There are guys out there that act the same way. But I think there's a lot of women out there that are so entitled, and they say whatever the hell they want online, and there's no repercussions. I mean, nobody to kick them in the teeth.
On YouTube, it's mostly guys.
What right. are you doing? The dog is just walking around the desk. So she'll take a dump right there.
Probably will. All the Black Friday Cyber Monday deals are here, and Lexar has one for you for this exact drive. In fact, if you're not familiar with Lexar, they make cards, card readers, SSD drives, all things that you can rely on and that I personally rely on as a professional photographer. Lexar's Black Friday deal only runs from November 21st to December 2nd, so make sure you snag this right away. They have 35% off the SL500 2 terabyte drive that I've got right here. It's super lightweight, compact. I use these things all the time. Throw them right in my bag. I travel a lot as a photographer, so the fact that they're very durable is really, really nice. If you want something even more durable, the Lexar Armor 700, their 4 terabyte version, is also up to 35% off. That one can take a beating. I'm grabbing some drives. Make sure you grab these deals in the link below. I have an exclusive link for you to get up to 35% off these SSD drives. If you're a photographer, Lord knows we can't ever have enough space, so I'm sure you'll snag these. Go ahead and grab these up to December 2nd. December 2nd. Back to the video. Well, that brings me to my next thing. So YouTube. So my friend Sydney, let me get to this. My friend Sydney, I'm realizing I don't even know how to pronounce your last name, dude. Yongzon. Anyway, he's a Sony creator, if I recall. Maybe not actually branded to anything, but YouTuber. He's awesome. And he said, he just posted, so what's up with people making hit pieces on other creators? Like, what's the point? Engagement baiting is getting ridiculous these days.
Is that what it is? It's engagement baiting. It's more about, like, I want to get as many people eyes on my stuff as possible.
It's using someone else's name to better yourself. And there, I know quite a few YouTubers that do this, and I'm not going to name names because I'm not going to do the thing I say I hate. They bash other creators, but some will literally make videos, like Jared, for example. Mm-hmm. I made a spoof video on him, but I made that video. I asked his permission to do that spoof.
Yeah, that
video.
Wasn't an attack because that was a coordinated thing.
Yeah, coordinated. Steven was in it. He gave me a picture of his background so we can green screen it. Like,
that was a Saturday Night Live skit. That's
what that was. And I sent it to him to approve beforehand. That's different. Jared gets people making videos about him, like bashing what he said or how he acted or what he thinks about this camera, which is also just who gives a crap.
Well, he is a public figure, though.
Fine. But,
and he's a well-known public figure. You're opening yourself up for attack.
Oh, please. I know. But people do that so that, you know, they get higher views on that.
Oh,
so,
yeah. Well, it's called it's called cotailing.
Cotailing, piggybacking.
It's cotailing. It's I'm going to leverage Vanessa's audience by making fun of her. Mm-hmm. A couple years back, I had put out like a little podcast episode, me and Charles sitting down talking about videographer pricing.
Yeah.
And I put out a spreadsheet, and I was basically saying, you don't make much being a videographer if you charge below a certain amount. And this dude made a response video.
Oh, my God. I had a guy do that.
And my response to him was, I didn't record another video responding. I just went on the video and I responded, I have no audience, but you have zero audience. Who is this for?
Yeah.
It's like, what are you trying to coattail off of me? I'm nobody.
Yeah.
Like, what is this? What is this about?
I had someone do that to me. I wrote an article on F-stoppers. It was, I think, 13 years ago at this point, maybe 10. And it was before cameras. You can't have those,
no
baby.
No cookies for you.
No, baby.
No, ma'am.
It was before I could trust mirrorless cameras to do wedding photography. And I wrote an article on why. And I wrote it to be a little bit controversial because it was F-stop prison at the time, or maybe it is still now. Like, it was just controversial. So it was like, well, this is what I think, because it was true. And I said I couldn't use mirrorless cameras professionally, and here's why. And this guy, again, I'm not going to name names, but this guy made a rebuttal video on YouTube. And at the time, he definitely had an audience, and I had people that would like, that had come up to me. Actually, Manny Ortiz, in the middle of an airport, before Manny Ortiz was Manny Ortiz, comes up to me. And he's like, oh, hey, I just wanted to say hi. I just wanted to meet you. And, you know that, I know you wrote that video about mirrorless cameras, and I use mirrorless cameras. And I'm like, and, you know, don't worry about that rebuttal video. And I'm like, what are you talking about? This was before I was even on YouTube.
What a way to learn about it.
Yeah, so this is how I find out. This guy made this rebuttal video about how I'm wrong, which I don't mind that as much, because that's, I wasn't the point of it, right? It was what I was saying.
Which is fine. Okay, but fine.
But so he made the rebuttal video, but then he took everything I said out of context and totally skewed what I said.
He spun it for his own
purposes, right? And then, you know, long fun story short, like, it came back around and something bit him in the butt and was involved in one of the, you know, little sexually abusing your models. So whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I feel like the photography industry, and this goes for videographers too, especially now, it's very toxic because, again, it's filled with a generation of young people who have never been punched in the teeth on the playground. And these people online, they don't suffer. There are no repercussions for their speech.
I don't think it's an age thing, though, personally. Because, I mean...
No, it's definitely with the older people can be jerks too.
I get it from all ages. Primarily old men is actually my biggest trolls.
Right. That's just coming out of insecurity, I think. I mean,
it's coming out of YouTube. YouTube audiences more women do.
It's so interesting because we talk about this a lot, how the photo industry has become so female-centric.
Yes.
I mean, it is completely shifted from 25, 30 years ago, where it used to be a male-dominated industry. Now it is very, very strongly female-dominated. And I think there's a lot of resentment from a lot of older guys because of that.
Yeah, I could see that. Do you think also, kind of going back to the consumer, do you think also that because a lot of photographers are women business owners, that has given some kind of easier to confront, easier to attack, I don't know, open door for consumers to do things like I mentioned, like complain about the price to the point of leaving a bad review because women are not as scary maybe as men. My thought process behind this, maybe I see a lot of it because I'm in the photo industry and of course that's what my algorithm is feeding me. But if you had someone who was charging a luxury price as a hair salon, and I guess that would be male or female, anything would, or a luxury price for a car, a Mercedes or a Ferrari, whatever, even for handbags, whatever it is, like, you don't see that kind of attack and bad reviews on those types of businesses, but we see it so much on that, like, small female business owned person. Like, how dare that small female charge that much money? But you would never say that about a big business or I don't know. Like, I find it interesting.
Two things to that point. Number one, I don't think it's because of a small female business. I think this, again, it goes back to there are no repercussions. So why wouldn't somebody just attack you online? Nobody's going to show up at your house, knock on the door and punch you in the teeth.
Well, they might.
Right? Well, and it's very rare and it might happen. And I'm sure there have been instances where online feuds have manifested into physical confrontations, but I don't think that's the norm. And I think people get away with it all the time. Mm. And then there is this default, the consumer is always right, to the point where a bad review can destroy a business. It could hurt a business very badly. The other side of that is that I forgot my freaking point. There was going to be another point to that. I just completely.
Rob is turning 50 next year.
Oh God, my
year.
Brain is going.
You got to take the ginkgo biloba and the body bio. I take the body bio helps.
The creatine's helping me a lot, believe it or not. It really is helping me. It's also the middle of my day. I have not showered yet today and I've been told to sit down on a podcast. So I'm kind of.
You know, we had to set up for something.
No. I'm happy to do it.
You know, our kids are going to come home in 3.5 minutes.
Yeah, no. And I just love being able to sit down and talk with you. It's always nice. In the middle of our day when things are always busy, I just wish I could forget. I wish I could remember my freaking point.
I should probably explain why my face looks like this while you think about your point. So, along with being old, my face looks like this because I did Halo, which is a resurfacing type laser. But you look like this for about a week. And you know what? I don't care. and this is the kind of crap I have to do so I don't get your dumbass comments about how tired you look. Oh, Vanessa, you look so tired. You should get some rest, baby.
Well, I agree that you need the rest, but you're always beautiful.
Oh, thanks.
And I remember my point, by the way. Oh, so good. Large businesses, like large brands, they do they catch a lot of heat. It just because they're so big, it doesn't affect them as much because their pool of customers and audience.
Like we are.
Well, who is taking it personally? This massive marketing department. Nobody's taking it personally until somebody gets fired because they did such a bad campaign like Bud Light. The big companies, if you look at any Instagram post, like for example, like there's a niches. You mentioned the car industry. Mm-hmm. I get a lot of targeted ads in my algorithm from like off-road vehicles, you know, Jeeps and stuff like that, right? And the new Jeep came out and I think it's ugly as sin. And I go on look at the comments because I want to see what other people are saying about it. And it's getting just eviscerated. I mean, it's getting torn apart with how ugly.
Nothing's going to beat that cherry red Wrangler on the right-hand drive.
I have one of the last true Jeeps. That's true. But what I'm saying is, like, there were probably 1,000 comments on this post, and they were all pretty majoratively negative.
It's ugly. It's too expensive.
That's not going to hurt the brand. I mean, now people may not buy it. They might not do the numbers, but you know, it's not going to bring the Daimler, Chrysler, Fiat, whatever it is down. It's not going to bring it down.
Well, it's not going to bring anyone down personally, but social proof definitely affects the company positive or negative.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it has to be on a large scale.
But I think you might have a point there. So, for example, you know, that big business is not going to take it personally, like I said, versus a small business. Not only is it going to take it personally, but it's going to post about it like that girl did, like I've done in the past, in hopes that they get some emotional support. And then nobody, you know, they get some, but then apparently it gets so bad you have to delete the thing you needed emotional support about.
Right. Well, what do you think is more effective? Coming out and saying something and addressing it publicly, or just shutting your mouth and just let it go away, like it fizzle out like a bad fart?
I mean, I don't know. All I know is I'm Italian Jersey girl and
you can't keep your mouth shut.
I can't keep my
mouth shut. Well, we know you have to have the last word. If anybody knows that, it's me. Sometimes I think it's best to just shut your mouth and let it go away. Like, unless it's a posted review, a one star, and you have the opportunity to rebut it, but don't get in that. Go into a tit for tat with somebody online. It's just the dumbest thing.
Tit for tat is bad. I think responding to reviews your side is good. Getting in a fight online is never good. Like, it could go different ways. I do respond, especially if they're being dumb. Like, I'm going to point out your stupidity for everyone to see.
If there's an obvious weakness there.
And attack me and you're dumb at the same time, like, you're going to get the back of my hand.
So that's the virtual kick in the teeth then.
Yeah.
Like, so you're hoping to inflict retribution and damage in some way by coming back at them.
I don't know that.
Otherwise, what's the impetus?
I'm usually defending myself. That's always my first, like, I demand a little bit of respect after my 20 something years in this industry and everything I've done. I think that's like defending myself, which is why if my fans, followers, whatever you want to call them, defend me first, you won't see me comment usually ever at all because like, it's usually about defending my integrity.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. And I feel like cancel culture.
R-I-S-P-E-C-T.
Get it, girl.
Find out what it means to me. Sorry.
I don't feel like cancel culture has the bite that it once did either. I think it's become so played out and it's just been so overdone and everybody's so sensitive that I think the pendulum is coming back the other way. And people are so tired of the sensitive nature of people online. It's just everybody bitching and moaning. It's like...
And my big thing, ye without sin cast the first stone because... Yep. And I don't care what that has to do
with... Frog with a glass ass hops but once, right?
I've never heard that. You know, it just goes with anything, whether you're thinking about bashing a creator or you're thinking about critiquing someone's photo. You can actually listen to Jared Polin's podcast. I think it was episode like 120 or something where I was on and he was talking about the fact that I yelled at him, like, stop sending me people's photos and telling me their photos suck. Like, because my whole thing is like, you know what? My photos sucked once too. Secondly, you don't know what the circumstances were for that particular job. And I don't know.
And thirdly, what is he sitting in a mahjong hall with a bunch of old ladies just bitching about other people and their work and what they do? Gives a shit.
I mean, he's not doing it publicly. He's just, you know, amongst friends. But it's just, I try to lead with sympathy and empathy in life. And you know what? I'm not perfect. And I love grace when I'm not perfect. So I'm going to lead with grace when I see other people not being perfect.
Of course, yeah.
The kids are going to be home soon. We got to wrap this up. Do you have any wise words?
Wise words? Rarely have wise words anymore.
Then we're going to leave with grace.
With grace.
Which is my daughter's physical name. Oh my God, my daughter's middle name.
Yeah, I can't speak today either. I'm having a hard time. I've also
haven't got a podcast. It's not poise anymore. It's demure.
Demure. Is that the new word?
Yeah.
That's the trend. I've seen the trend online. Demure, like, it's so demure. Cutesy. I can't. That's another thing I can't stand. I can't stand all these freaking trends anymore. I'm so over people being influencers. I'm so tired of people trying to be cute and funny. You're not cute and funny. You're copying somebody else and you're fucking lame. Stop doing it. No, I can't.
I'm not cute.
Instagram, you're cute, funny? But you're leveraging it. I know why you do it.
Why I do what?
You do it for business.
Which part?
All of the cute trends. Like, you're doing it to build your audience and for engagement.
Sometimes.
Some people are just doing it for attention.
I think things are funny.
Screw all this trendy TikTok crap that I see.
Stop bashing other creators. That's where we started.
I'm not bashing creators. I'm just tired of the culture. Everybody. It seems like everybody, I'm worried about our kids having to grow up and feel like they have to create content in order to be social with people.
Kids are home. We gotta go. Perfect. Bye.
Way to dump out of that quick.